All right, I have bought so much makeup and nail polish lately that I'm having to reorganize. This is a nail polish station. I'm not sure the brand it was. I know it came from a pink box. I have all that. And then I'm trying not to show myself in the mirror because I look like death. Then this is where I keep all the stuff I use nightly, all my skin stuff. There's some makeup in this drawer. This drawer is just disgusting. Let's just not even talk about it. Then there is this whole cake rack full of stuff that, this stuff is hard to use because I can't find anything, and it is disappointing because I love those products. And then we're getting to the really terrible part is down here. In this drawer, this is my brushes, and then my Vice 2 palettes, my Vice 1 and 2 palette. And then over here is my hair stuff. This drawer is fine. It looks messy, but it's not. All right, now here's the bad one. In the cabinet is like a gigantic bin of disgustingness. When I had just minimal makeup, I had like 6 products I used every day. I kept all of my makeup in this. So, yeah. But that's not the case anymore. I reorganized into a train case. And then I filled up the train case, so I switched to the nail polish station up here. But now that's not even working out for me. So, I'm going to pull out all of my makeup and set it on the floor, and I'll be right back. So these are the things I want to relocate. I've got this whole bin of stuff, which we'll go through in a second. My skin stuff, I'd like to move to a more convenient and sanitary place. And then this hair cake pan thing is disgusting. It's hard to use, it's hard to find things. So now I'm just going to empty out this bin, empty out up here, and empty, well, I'm going to leave that stuff in there for right now until I can figure out what I want to do with it. But, and then I'll show you what all is in these two things. Okay, so I emptied out the bin, which looks super gross, and I emptied out the top of this. That's all that's here. There's nothing else. I didn't empty out the eye rack, literally the bin in the top, and like, look at all this. Okay. So obviously I have issues. So let me just quickly go through kind of what's in here. These are all samples that I haven't ever bothered to use. I've got e.l.f. products, lots and lots of e.l.f. products that I either didn't like or I don't know. Some of these I just haven't used. Like, I don't know why I bought that color. I don't wear bright blue anything. So I don't really like all these are crazy insane colors. Like, look at that. That's lime green. That's scary. There's moisturizer over there. I use this moisturizer usually in the winter because it's so heavy. I have BB cream that I don't use that I thought I would, but I lied to myself. Pore cleansing strips. I haven't used these since the 8th grade. Did these expire? Because if they do, they're expired. I mean, I don't think they do. Who knows? Anyways, the makeup removing wipes. I love these, but I use them for heavy makeup. So like prom, I used, actually I didn't prom, why did I say prom? I didn't even go to prom. To when we went to see the Book of Mormon, I used one of those because I had a full face on. Eye cream that I didn't like, Better Than False Lashes, which I love, but I never can see because it's buried under all this. These are just different eyeshadows that I have. These are pretty much all lip products and some perfumes. Now, all this stuff came from up there. That all of this was shoved up there. There's a cat liner, or a liquid liner. Razors, blotting paper, more samples, more e.l.f. products, mascara, lip gloss, lots of nail polish. I love these colors, or else I wouldn't have even bothered to keep them. But I just don't have room for them up with the rest. This is all my skin stuff that I don't use and will probably never use again. And these are all my palettes. I like these palettes, most of them. The e.l.f. one, which is on top, I don't really care for. The quality is very, very lacking. But most of the products I do like, just not that eyeshadow palette. These are, I don't even know why I have this stuff, okay? These are allergy relief eye droplets that I haven't used for over a year. These are my current contacts, so I need those. These are old contacts. This isn't even my prescription anymore. It's like a point behind. These are my old glasses. I can't wear them.
Vicks I actually use, but just in the winter time. And then a stack of headbands that I wear when I get ready for bed. So now I'm going to go through all of this and separate what I want and what I don't want into two piles, and I'll be back. Okay, so here's what I'm down to. Two piles. These I'm actually going to keep. Okay. I'm trying to get this cupcake tier thing down to all hair and perfume products. So right now that's all it is. That and my Urban Decay All-Nighter Makeup Setting Spray, which I love and use religiously. So I just want to keep that on there. Also, my Clinique face wash is on there just because it's so large. I think this is actually a jumbo package of it. I love it. I use it twice a day. So I keep that up there as well. My beauty blender is up there, which I don't actually ever use. That was actually, I think, the Ulta brand one. So it was only like a dollar, which is a good thing because I don't use it. And then all this is stuff I'm getting rid of. I'm getting rid of the maracuja oil, which I know I just said that I liked it, but I changed my mind because it stinks. And I can't handle putting something that smells horrible on my face. I figured I should tell you why I don't like this e.l.f. palette. You can see that I've only used it a few times. I bought this at a TJ Maxx type of store, where it's discounted anyway, so it's discounted even further from what the e.l.f. price would be. So they're just chalky. Very chalky, very difficult to use, especially the matte ones down here, which is the main reason I bought this. I bought this palette because of these four colors and these bottom ones to try to create a smoky eye. And they're just chalky, and the color payoff isn't what it should be. And since I do have the nicer palettes, I have my Naked and my Naked 2 and Naked 3 and even the Victoria's Secret palette, then I just don't need to fight with them. So I just don't even want to bother. I'm getting rid of my old glasses, some mascara, some skin products. This, I just don't think it cleans. And this is a foam, and I don't think it cleans. So I've learned my lesson. Don't buy any more foams. I think my mom's going to look through all this to see if she wants any. So maybe she'll post something at the end to see what she kept or what she didn't keep. This brush I'm sure she'll keep because it's a nice brush. I'm pretty sure it came with my Hoola palette. My Hoola box bronzer. But I just don't use it. I have other brushes that I like. And so that's what I'm getting rid of. In here are all my small lip gloss type things that I want to use daily, but I can't because I can't see them. I'm keeping my Clinique toners. There's some moisturizers down there. Of course I'm going to keep my Victoria's Secret palette, my Vice 1 and Vice 2 palette. This is a palette that I bought from Gordman's. And as you can see, I tested the nail polish color on it because I was, I think, 12 when I got this. And I like it still. These are more bright colors, and I use them when I'm going to a bright party or a summer party or something like that. So you can tell the colors that I've liked. I used to wear this brown and this light purple every single day throughout 8th grade, and I loved it. That highlighter's gone. That brown is almost gone. I've hit pan on quite a few of these. But, I mean, it's lasted for forever. And then I'm getting rid of all of those headbands. I have one that I use, and I'm keeping that up there. Most of these are dollar store headbands. I think you buy... I know with these, if they came in a pack of three. So, I think it was this one and this one. And then I have the black one. And the black one is the one that I actually use. And I will never actually wear those out. This one I had for Jesus prom, which is a prom that my church puts on for special needs, for those afflicted with special needs, just so they have a prom to go to as well. And the theme was, I think, dancing through the decades, and so I was a 70s hippie, so I wear that headband. Anyways, more of what I'm keeping. I'm keeping all of the e.l.f. eyeshadow sticks because I like them when I need to get out the door. I'm keeping my Vicks, my Better Than False Lashes. You'll be able to see this stuff better when I figure out how to organize it. I had my dad bring this down from, it's just a four-drawer shelf. I had him bring it down from upstairs because I never used it up there. And my mom had the idea of putting little baskets in it to try to separate it and make it where my makeup was visible, because I was complaining that I can't see everything. Even up here, I have things layers upon layers of stuff, and I just can't see it anymore. And if I can't see it, I'm not going to use it. So this is part one, was just figuring out what I want to keep and what I don't want to keep. And the next step will be organizing all of this into that.
Okay, I have divided everything out into things I want to keep. The glasses case actually have glasses in them. I will donate them to the Lions Club. I will probably keep this hard case because it's nice. This is actually Halloween makeup, and we have a bag for Halloween makeup, so I'll put that in there because it's pricey. This stuff I'm going to offer to Christina. Lip stuff, eyeshadow, things like that. Hair treatment. She has beautiful, thick, thick, thick hair. And this is Clinique, so I hate to just throw that away. The last pile is... Ashley said this was in bad shape. This is all mascara, and I don't share mascara with anyone because of eye infections. Contacts, nobody's going to be able to wear those, and those are papers.
Alright, so today I went to the dollar store to get a few organizing containers. I just got a few because I don't know what I'll want, which will work, which won't. And if any of these don't fit, I'll take them back. I got two slim long ones. And I got two like rectangle-ish ones, and they're medium size. I like these. I think these will work. And then I bought this one for my palettes, and I hope that that will work. So I'm going to take some of my makeup and put them into this, and then I'll show you how that works. Okay, so I have finished organizing. This, I was able to get two containers off of it and just put what I want up here. This is all hair stuff, a perfume bottle, and two Blistex because I use them all the time. Also, the Vaseline is up there because I use that all the time. This is still my hair drawer. This drawer... I took the palettes out of it and put in my saline solution. Now the big change is down here in the cabinet. I was able to clear out most of this. This is literally an empty case that I'll use when I go on overnight trips. And that is a basket full of samples and a beauty blender that I don't use. I was able to completely empty this clear box that did hold all of my skin products. Another big change is the wall. It's all nail polish now, and I have two empty shelves. And then the bottom is all of my lipsticks. Then over here in the chest of drawers, in the top drawer, I've got my skin stuff that I use every single day, my powders and all that that I use every single day, and my foundation stuff that I use every single day. Or most days, I should say. Then in the second drawer are all of my palettes. The third drawer, okay. Now this bin in the blue on the right, that's stuff that I use all the time. There are some of my favorite lip products are in there, but I just don't have space for them anywhere else. So I didn't cover those up. They're just there. And I would have put them back on the shelf, but these are products that don't really stand up. They're oddly shaped. These are products that I use once in a blue moon. I'd hardly ever use some of these, but they're things I just didn't want to get rid of. And then these I use a lot, but not every day. Like my makeup removing pen, when I want to rock a cat eye, I use that. Ignore the lipstick swatch on my hand. I was organizing my lipsticks and I had to swatch one to figure out what color it was. And then the last drawer, this is my extras drawer. So I have extra Clinique toner, the mini thing of Clinique toner. VapoRub, two moisturizers. I use this one in the winter and I sometimes use that with mixed with a concealer. My Clinique eye creams down here that I'd never use. These are both backups. So when those run empty, I'll have them already here. honestly, my I bought a little travel size of those as a set, and it lasted so much longer than I thought. I just hit pan on it, but that is the bathroom. It's much cleaner, much more usable, and I'm super excited.